What is up, guys? My name is Dylan, and this channel is dedicated to helping you improve your filmmaking and video editing skills. Today, we're gonna go over two ways that you can add text behind moving objects in Final Cut Pro, the blend mode method and the masking method.
This blend mode method is a really simple way to do it. However, it doesn't work with every shot, but when it does work, it only takes a minute to do. We'll be changing the blend mode of the text so it'll appear behind dark areas in your shots. It is the easiest method out of the two, but it is important to note that your shot will need to have high contrast between the background and what you want in front of the text. Silhouettes work the best. So take this shot. Our subject is pretty much a silhouette in front of this bright, clear sky, so this shot is perfect for the blend mode method. Add text to your shot by pressing the shortcut Ctrl+T and adjust your text to what you like. Something worth mentioning is that this method won't work with black text and generally just really dark text, unless what you want in front of the text is completely black as well. So click your text, head to your inspector window, and head to blend mode. Generally, there are two options you will use here: darken and multiply. Multiply is going to be the best option when the thing passing in front of the text is very dark. If your shot is a perfect shot for the blend mode method, then use multiply. This blend mode tends to keep the color of the text more than using darken, but if it changes, open up a color board or color wheels and adjust. Darken is probably what you'll use the most though. However, it does take some tweaking to get right sometimes. This mode is more useful if the thing or person you want in front of the text isn't that dark. They still have to be a fairly dark exposure for it to work though. Notice that if I change this to multiply, what we used last time, the text spills onto our subject. If we use darken, it still does slightly, but we can adjust it. If you open a color board or color wheels and start to raise the shadows, you'll find a point where the text will fall behind the subject. You'll notice that with this method, the text isn't always solid though, unless the background is plain. So like I said before, you may need to tweak and adjust the saturation and exposure of the text. If you want to add text behind an object and not have to worry about the text being a little translucent, you can go with the masking method. This method is definitely more tedious, but it's going to be pretty precise and effective for most shots. It'll also allow you to put the text behind whatever object you want, regardless of its shade. So we have this drone shot, and I want to put some text behind the very top of these two buildings. To save time, I'll show you how to do just one building for now. The blend mode method obviously won't work here, so let's create a mask. Go to your effects browser and add a draw mask to your title. This is going to allow us to cut out the part of the title so it appears to be behind this building. Something that's kind of annoying with adding masks to titles is that when you go to add control points, Final Cut won't let you make the points directly over the title. At least I haven't figured out a way to combat this yet. So just move the title up and start creating points around whatever it is you'd like the title to appear behind. You may need to zoom in to better see the outline. A tip if your object is curved is to hold and drag the mouse and you can create a Bezier curve, which is basically just a line that's not straight. These points right here increase the intensity of the curve. Because the title won't be going down here, you won't need to make this part precise. Connect the points and your mask is made. Drag the title into the position and we will click Invert Mask so the area that's cut out is everything inside that shape we made. Something that's useful to play with is the feathering of the mask. If I zoom in here, you'll notice that by adding a bit of feathering, it can help to make the effect look more natural and fit better. This is a video though and not a picture, so our shot obviously will be moving. That means we need to keyframe our mask so it stays on this building the whole time. Click all of your transform and control points, so every time we move a point, it saves. And all we'll do is skip a couple, three or so frames by using the right arrow key and adjust the mask. Skip three frames and adjust, skip three frames and adjust, and so on. The reason we skip a couple frames and not go frame by frame is because Final Cut will automatically guess the path of our last saved points to our new ones. If we adjust every frame, our mask could look jittery on playback. Adjusting every three or so frames will allow our mask to be a little more fluid. After you finish adjusting the mask, you may need to review the path of it and make some minor tweaks to the position of it since Final Cut isn't always perfect at guessing the path. This masking method can be fairly easy if all you have to do is draw some straight lines for a mask, or it can be pretty difficult if the thing you're masking is getting bigger and smaller and has lots of moving parts. I've spent hours working on masks and minutes on others. I hope you find these two methods useful.
If this video taught you a thing or two, do me a solid and press the thumbs up button, and let me know what you're gonna use this text effect for in the comment section below. If you wanna learn more about Final Cut Pro, I have a lot of other, hopefully useful tutorials on my channel, so give the channel a look after this and consider subscribing. Have a great day, guys.